Welcome back to STL TV Live. I'm Sarah Bernard, and she's been a vital part of feeding the homeless in the St. Louis area and started her own organization that she named LACE, which stands for Ladies After Community Enrichment. I'm happy to welcome Nakia Gist. Welcome, Nakia.
Hi, thank you for having me.
So you were inspired to help the homeless in St. Louis. Is homelessness a big problem that you can see in our city?
Yes. I know the numbers in North County are very high. I don't know the numbers in downtown as of today. But there are over 1,800 children documented as homeless in three area school districts
in North County alone. So are you focusing mostly in North County with your work?
No, we do work in North County once a week, and once a month we go throughout the streets of downtown St. Louis and feed the homeless.
Once a week?
I mean, once a week in,
downtown.
In North County,
okay.
And then once a month.
Downtown.
Downtown.
Okay,
yes.
Got it. So you're busy. You're out there somewhere
yes.
every week helping people. So you were telling me earlier that 5 years ago you were inspired to start helping in our community.
Yes.
And then you formalized the process with LACE a couple years ago.
Yes, it started with a conversation I had with a gentleman who was telling me how much food goes to waste at the end of the day at different restaurants, mm-hmm. area restaurants. Mm-hmm. And we started getting food from the food banks. And we would take that food and make sandwiches and lunches and take it downtown. My kids started helping me so that they could do community service for graduation.
Mm-hmm.
And then some of my friends wanted to get involved. So that's how LACE came about.
So how many people encompass LACE today?
23.
As of today.
Yes.
That's a lot.
Yes.
You've really grown. You must be really proud.
Yeah.
And are you doing this full time then?
Pretty much, yes. Mm-hmm. I do this full time along with Charlotte's Community Outreach.
So let's go back to where the food is coming from. So your friend 5 years ago was telling you about the waste
mm-hmm.
that he saw in
yes.
the restaurant
yes.
industry in St. Louis. And so then did you reach out to the restaurants? Was that where you first started?
It's difficult because they're leery to donate what's left over. A lot of restaurants and stores still just throw their food away at the end of the day or the end mm-hmm. of the week. So a majority of what we do comes from donations. So we do a lot of networking on social networks and just soliciting people.
So donations from individuals?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Interesting.
Yes.
So and how do you canvas neighborhoods to get donations, or is it friends who are doing the work for you?
It's friends, word of mouth. We use Twitter, Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
So we're on the social networks, and then other people with organizations, they'll put the word out that we're in need of certain things.
Mm-hmm.
And we help other charities as well. So in the process of us helping other people, they also put the word out that we're in need of certain donations.
Okay, so how are you working with other charities exactly?
We support other charities. Once a month, LACE supports another charity. Like this month, well, for June, we'll be supporting Share My Kicks. We'll have an event, flip-flop event on Saturday.
Mm-hmm.
And we've been collecting flip-flops for women and children in area shelters.
So what happens specifically this Saturday? Can people bring flip-flops that they purchase?
They can bring flip-flops. They can contact us on the web or on Facebook, or either call the hotline number to donate flip-flops. And all those flip-flops will go to ladies and children living in area shelters that are suffering from domestic violence.
Wow, you are really hitting a lot of different needs in our community.
Yeah.
So it's interesting that you're using social media. I'm guessing that when you first envisioned this organization 5 years ago, social media probably wasn't on the forefront of your thoughts.
No, I wasn't even on Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
People persuaded me to get on Facebook, and then mm-hmm. I began to utilize it as a tool. But it just started as word of mouth and me just asking people for donations, and now people just jump on board. No matter what we're doing, we're able to reach our goals.
So how can our viewers find out more about how they can help you specifically?
They can contact me. They can contact our hotline, 636-395-0833, or they can find us on Facebook. There's LACE has a page on Facebook. Charlotte's Community Outreach has a page.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have a website, charlottescommunityoutreach.com.
So there's lots of ways to help.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
And fun things to do.
Yes.
So can people come and actually help in when you distribute food on Tuesdays?
Of course. Of course. We're at Barak Church in North County on mm-hmm. Hanley Road at 270. We're there at 5 p.m. every Tuesday serving the families in North County that are living in the area hotels.
Mm-hmm.
And so we welcome volunteers. And even when we go down once a month downtown on the streets of downtown St. Louis, we welcome volunteers.
Yeah, and I bet it's a lot of fun. It's a great way to build a new community and create a community for everybody too.
Yeah, it's humbling. It's an eye opener. But
mm-hmm.
The more people that we get to help, the more the word will get out of what
Absolutely.
The need is.
So we're going to take a quick break right now, Nakia, but we're going to come back and talk to James Brooks, who's going to be joining us to hear about how he's also working with Nakia. So stay with us.